When you Google Emily Giffen, one of the things that comes up in the description of your novels is chick lit. Mm-hmm. We talked a little bit about this earlier. I'd like to know how do you describe the novels that you've written and your stories, the stories that you tell, and what do you have to say about that being dubbed chick lit?
Yeah, I could talk. I could give a whole talk on this. You know, I think of what I write is generally as women's fiction. Mm-hmm. You know, that's kind of how it's dubbed. Although I do think this is the first book that I've written that men could, you know, will really enjoy. Mm-hmm. I've heard that men don't read fiction as much as it's like 80% of all novels are bought by, you know, and then men read more nonfiction, but there's exceptions to that. But the chick lit, you know, the chick lit, it's a tough one to answer because. Yeah. I think it's really more of a marketing label, and I think it's a function of when I first published. So when I wrote Something Borrowed, the mm-hmm. title, the working title of the manuscript was called Rolling the Dice. There's a scene where she rolls the dice, and this question of like fate versus, you know, how you control your own destiny. And the book really ends in with a little bit of a bittersweet note mm-hmm. and a melancholic ending. And so it's not your typical... You know, if it were made into, well, it was made into a movie, wasn't it?
Made into a movie.
But it's not like the typical, I mean, one of the things that was difficult to sell is like the protagonist is doing such an unlikable, unsympathetic thing. Mm-hmm. So that's a little different from your, you know. So in other words, I think what happened was it was the explosion of this genre called chick lit with Bridget Jones' Diary. Mm-hmm. I was publishing then. My editor called and said, we want... Rolling the Dice isn't going to work for us as a title. That sounds like a guy book about gambling. We need something girly. And I'm like, okay, girly. And I just kept thinking My Best Friend's Wedding.